Now there is no short circuit on the board. The problem in microcontroller. Microcontroller supply line is damaged. VCC bus is damaged in this microcontroller. Now no need to repair it because this microcontroller is damaged. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Friends, welcome back to my channel. I have this Beko WMB71033S washing machine control board. It is dead. It is not powering on. Let's see what's wrong here. If you don't have good experience in electronics, never try to repair because here are live voltage. Always take care for the safety. I will apply power using series LED. We will connect power input line at this terminal and this terminal. If you place in this way, the bottom side terminal and this terminal. AC voltage. Never touch any component when power is applied. Volt at input socket. There is some sound. But there is no display, just only this one LED is blinking. Let's see what's wrong here. Tick tick sound. And there is no display. Let's open it. Here it is using LNK3643. This is sign of humidity or water damage. Might be the water is entered here. You can see this component as well. I think it is TL431. And this optocoupler. you will apply power here and here. Capacitors are looking good. DC voltage. Check DC voltage on this main capacitor. It is almost stable, but there is fluctuation. Why stop fluctuating? DC voltage. Yes, it is fluctuating. The feedback is missing here because VCC capacitor voltage present. This optocoupler 816A. Yes, this optocoupler gone. This optocoupler is not giving indication in diode mode. Its LED side is open. Yes, this optocoupler is good. This optocoupler 1 volt. This optocoupler open circuit. If this optocoupler is damaged, might be its TL431 is also damaged. First we will install it and then we will check it. Here we have 5 volt now. In this side, 21 VCC, 22 ground. We will check supply here. 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. Reset pin is high. But its reset pin is high. Reset pin must be low. There is something wrong on VCC circuit. Still there is something wrong. Pin number 52 is also VCC. These two capacitors. Still there is something wrong. We have something short circuit on DC supply line. I will disconnect this line. I disconnected here. I will disconnect this line from here. Now I isolated this area here. Still there is something charge. Same positive voltage reaching here, coming to this chamber. Here is this C3. Now I disconnected the power line VCC voltage for this processor, but still it is giving short circuit. That is strange. I disconnected the processor supply from this point. That is reaching here from this jumper. I disconnected the supply, but still it is giving short circuit air supply and ground pin. That means this processor, this chip is damaged. Let's remove its supply pins. Yes, this is the problem. The problem in microcontroller. Microcontroller supply line is damaged. VCC bus is damaged in this microcontroller. Now there is no short circuit on the board. Microcontroller damaged. Now no need to repair it because this microcontroller is damaged. I am happy that we repaired the power supply and we found the problem. When we find any pinpoint troubleshooting, that means our work is perfect. Might be this processor damaged due to fluctuation in the supply line. After this complete troubleshooting process, we detected that VCC bus of this chip is damaged. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it is good, like it. If you have any questions, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.